Well, hello there, and welcome to a brand new and rather impromptu campaign, just because of how excited I got by it. We're going to play as the Britons of Daffyd, or Demet in someone else's language. The starting year is 452 AD. Rome has left the Isle and is now situated down here. We are charged with defeating Gwynedd, which is this nation up here, the other Welsh faction. And we are charged, oh dear, with defeating the Cornish kingdom of Dumnonia. All of these names are new to me. And what I wanted to do was accept that we're going to have a loss straight off the bat. I have not played more than five turns of a campaign. I played a little bit as York, this faction up here, mainly because it makes decent profits. And it's the only one, if you go through the British Isles, significant losses, heavy losses, significant losses, hemorrhaging cash. And then down here is break even and easy. But this faction down here is also in Gaul or France. So I didn't want to be them. I wanted to be just on the British Isles. Now, one thing I can tell you, and we'll get into the campaign, there is one faction that is classed as raking it in. So this faction down here in what might be Belgium and Calais, I think, this is where the money is. But we're not going to be them. We're going to be the Welsh. We have a heady mix of local Britonic population and Joidelic settlers. We've got a limited choice of cavalry as a disadvantage, and we have very little heavily armoured infantry. We have a poor economy, and we are constantly under the threat of Irish raiders. This has seemed to be quite a thing when I've only done the five turns. But this faction here, which owns two on the north coast of Wales, the Liginians, they just love invading Gwynedd. There's an invasion from Muster that happens down here as well, but we'll see how it goes. I'm pretty sure that if you're on this eastern seaboard, everyone from here jumps across. And if you're on the western seaboard of Britain, everybody from in here jumps across. So we shall see how it goes. I don't know any of the scripts. I don't know any of the events. So we shall explore it all together. I have to kill this faction and take 30 regions, which should be interesting. Our first problem is going to be the fact that we have a poor economy. Well, we can all gather round and explore it all together. Oh, hello. Have I left the toggle fog of war off? Because I don't know where any settlements are, so we'll take that off straight away so I don't have the advantage. Insularis Draco. This is not the island of the dragon. This is the challenge to become the dragon of the island. I did get that wrong on the previous overview. So, here we go. We are the Demet, or the people of Daffyd. You get a little bit of a history bit here. If you would like, I'm not going to read it out. If you'd like to know about it, I shall just give you enough time to pause and read. It is incredibly in-depth, and I get the impression that there's nothing I can do apart from play it and get used to it. There are certain things that are really interesting, honest. Lucrative plunder. Raiding and sacking cities seems to be a very intelligent way of getting money in this. Your units really do cost quite a lot on this version, so we'll have a look at that. You've got from the 4th to the 7th century, and the idea is to get your faction leader to be recognized as the dragon of the island. So there's a bit of role playing involved in that. We have legitimacy, bloodlines, and social strata. So essentially, what all of this means is you can actually put yourself into a civil war, which is fabulous. The battles, there's a slight difference. Missiles and cavalry make a huge difference, whilst the shield wall tends to be a lot of pushing and shoving with sticks involved, and not many people die according to this, but I haven't really. I've got into one battle and it crashed, so positive thoughts, everybody. You got monasteries, no one really cares, I'm not a religious man. But you can pick your religion, so I can pick between Catholic Christianity, Pelagian Christianity, and Druidism. And all I've got to do is build the largest building in my chief court of Prim Lis Demet, which is the state of Caer Myrddin. Right, all of that all done. We lose 6 grand. So it's all good. We've got 4 starting regions. We've got Miniu on the coast. We've got our main settlement of Caer Myrddin. We've got Treb Coch in the actual highlands of central Wales. And we have Caer Lynn over here in the east. Now, what we need to do, we have no agents. So that's the first thing that we're going to do. I don't know if we can actually recruit a ship. We can, but I'm not sure we want to. We lose 6 grand. So what we've got to do is pull all of our forces together that we want to keep. Can I bring all of you out? Yes, I can. So that's a good start. What do I want to keep from them? They're rubbish. Oh, they're not really. Defense 22. I just don't know. That's the problem that I've got. These are awesome. Look at these. These are our champions. They got a defense of 34. But they cost 550. So what we've got to do is find a way of grouping an army together and...
By your command.
So we can't lower the taxes. And disbanding some of the units or getting them killed off. You cost 230 and you cost 450, so let's see if we can put you in there. Sir. 75, still not good enough. So we're going to have to build something that gives us shooting targets. These are all upgraded in your units, we don't really care about that. At the minute, we need something that gives me population control. Chieftain's Hall, there you go. We're going to have one of them. And I'm assuming that cavalry unit is well expensive. We also need, where can we build a messenger from? Let's get, a messenger is a diplomat on this version. We do need them. And we can only build it in one place. Right, we're Welsh. So in my head, that means we want to have archers. So there's some bowmen there. We're currently going to lose 10,000. So we're going to move you up.
Yes.
To our, essentially where we're just going to muster our forces. Now he's kept for free in there, but he's a good general, he's untouched by fear. He's a druid. Am I meant to be druist? Hang on a minute, hang on, let's go and have a look. What's my actual, we're 40% Catholic, we're 20%, shall we become druid? shall we see what happens if we just mess around with the culture conversion? Let's all be druid. Let's do that. Because I don't know what effect it has on me. So we've decided on episode 1 that we're going to be druids, which is lovely. So let's get that built everywhere. Now you seem to be
my king.
The actual garrison unit. So we can do that. We can move him out. That's fine. All of y'all are going to come back down here. He's coming and he's coming. So what do we want to train? Irish pirates. Seem fine. I don't know, is the answer. We're going to disband any of these mounted javelins because I want my only cavalry to be these fellas, the Joydelic Lancers. And we've got all of them, that's fine. Essentially, what we're going to do is just group an army up and hope for the best. We've got 7 grand, and we're going to only have 1,000 left over, so we could do with a couple of watchtowers to have a look at the world.
Very well, sir.
If you could build one there, that would be nice.
Yes, my liege. This tower will keep vigil over the lands.
No, we can't. We can't get there. So back you go.
We shall continue tomorrow, my liege.
Quickly, because he's about to rebel. Ugh, I've made a cock up already. It's so annoying. Right, we're only going to have 791. What on earth? We're going to build one of them just in case. And we're just going to have to see how it goes. So that's the first turn done. Our first port of call is, I know that there's a settlement somewhere down here. So we're going to head there. We're going to hope for the time being that Daffyd and Gwynedd can get along in Wales. We're going to hopefully get trade with them. That's my plan. Time of Saints and Druids. And we've made a bit of a boo-boo because he's left the city. There you go, that's all sorted. Nice and nice. Seasonal report. You lost 12 grand. So we've recruited some units in some territories. We don't really know what's going on. That one is going to have a better population control when we get there.
We can go no further today, sir.
Now this, a green sort of random Celtic, this is the sort of the rebels or the free people, I suppose. And we're going to group everybody up. And then we're going to go this way across the coast. That is me plan. I have planned it. And all things like that, we're going to lose 7. Oh, I didn't move my diplomat. Now, what we're going to be doing in this campaign. Oh, hello. If I go and talk to Gwynedd, I get some military units. Where is my... He's in Trebcoch.
Yes, sir.
Oh, we nearly found
I shall
them.
Continue
They're
tomorrow,
up here somewhere.
Sire. Stopping here, sire.
Now, what we're going to cross our fingers and pray to the total war gods is that we don't get a crash. This does not appear as stable as I would want it. Now, what are you? You're 58, Catholic. Are you Catholic? I don't want you to be. This man has a belief in the Trinity and tenets of Christianity and short Catholicism. I've decided to be a druid, so I'm not sure that's going to be very helpful. Alright, let's... He's my general or household bodyguard. Fighting is nearby, free upkeep. I'm not sure he's actually a horse. So that might be an issue as we get to it. We've got the Sajid Bowman. 8 attack for a missile and 14 defense. These are 7 and 11. So these are our elite ones. Oh, we've got something called a marksman. So let's put all of these fellas together just so it looks nice and organized. And I cannot stress enough how I'm playing it purely on the back of, oh my god, this looked really cool, so I'm going to give it a go. And then people have just... The overview that I did has got an insane number of views. So I thought, oh Christ, I better get something out on the mod as I put it there. Could we take all of them? We can take another one, but... Ah, we can change the tax, didn't you? So we don't... We've got a little army, so let's... Oh! Let's have you go back there.
As you wish. An honor, sire.
We could have another horse.
My leave.
I'm very conscious of the fact I don't have an awful lot of infantry units. 1122, 1228. So these are better. The Irish pirates are better. So let's
an honor, sire.
Let's go and meet up with this fella here. And then we can group up. There you go.
Yes.
Turn two done, and we're only 14 grand in debt or something stupid like that. It's very reminiscent of a medieval total war campaign with the Woodland Realm. We've got a wife, Lunet of Mylar.
Without question, sire.
And we're going to get some proposition for fellas. Very generous. Ooh, map information is generous. You're bankrupt, so there's no point asking you for money. Oh, I didn't look at what it was called. Oh, shall we just have a guess? Oh, no. No, they don't want to do that. I give you an alliance, will you give me Bremi? No, that seems completely beyond there. So why don't we just become friends with the Welsh? Exactly, Pig. Because they're wonderful people.
This seems quite reasonable.
Ah, so look, we're now friends with them.
Well, that seems fruitful.
And we've got all their map.
Farewell.
So we've unified Wales. Ooh, and you get a little message every time you encounter someone that you've never met before. So what have I got? Hang on a minute. Oh, hello. We've bumped into other people as well.
Ships ready.
Ah, we've got four ships that we just don't care about. Well, we'll keep one just in case we need to nip across. I don't know what this is called. This is the this is where Bristol is in modern day Britain. I can't help you any more than that, I'm afraid. I just don't know. If we put the horse there.
An honor, sire.
And then the others can be hopefully what we garrison whatever we're about to whatever we're about to attack. So we're friends with the other Welsh faction. Now we don't need now that this faction over here. Ooh, shite!
Be gone! You are.
We've got a rebel. Warband, the brigands. So they spawn. That's interesting. We lose 9,000 to go. Can we get rid of you because does that make a difference? No. Let's save the 200 there. Everybody who we're paying for that we do not need. Can you come out?
Yes.
What's that? 75%.
Orders. As you wish.
Is it to 85? We have to keep him for a bit.
Your will, sire. An honor, sire.
Sod it. Let's just go and take it. Let's go and take a settlement and see what happens. We can't do anything other than that and just see how the game progresses, really. Once we've got an army and we've taken something, we'll know a little bit more about where we're going with it and what units are crap. And that's my plan. Consulship of Opilani and Vincomayo. Rejoice, rejoice, of independence, we've all been saved. Attila has suffered a severe nosebleed and choked to death in a drunken stupor. divine deliverance. I mean, it was poisoned, essentially, is what we're trying to talk to. Trying to get across. Ooh.
Your Majesty.
Now, hang on a minute. They've got a full army there. Now, there should be somewhere over here.
As you wish.
They own...
Tomorrow's journey.
Ah, yeah, we're going to talk to them over here. We get 3 grand. That's important. It's very important indeed. Something's happened in Fife.
Yes.
There we go. We've found it.
Sire.
So if we pop you all in there, do you get only one of you gets to
fit. This is English soil now.
Of bloody course. Ah, that's nice and free. We're only losing 7,900 now. Ooh. Ka-ching. So essentially this is going to be the episode. The Siege of Ker-Legion Gwa-Usik. Again, apologies to any Gaelic. If you're Gaelic, or if you can speak Gaelic or Welsh, I am so sorry. I think if it's got the
Sire,
the bloody hell is that?
The enemy surrounds us. Come and get me, you coward.
Well, when we've
an honour, sire.
Won
as
this
you will,
battle,
my king, to battle.
We're going to have to go north with the army. It's a good job that we cleverly thought.
We
we're going to need a garrison. I think Ker-Legion means that it's a Roman fort. That is shocking. Minus 33,000 at the minute, and we're going to go minus 41. What on earth? This game, we haven't built anything. Ah! Hopefully they don't... Ah, good. So we can talk to the people of Ligon. And hopefully they shall give us some money as well. We get 3 grand for the pleasure of talking to them. And hopefully that helps us somewhat. Yeah, it's the Free Nations, that's that green faction that's... Consulship of Aetius and Studius. Dire news from Rome. Victory over the Hun and defender of the Empire has been treacherously murdered at the Imperial Court in Ravenna. Rumours say that the Emperor, Valentine III, murdered him with his own hands. Ooh. Okay. And what's this say? Elsewhere we hear that from Rome that the Easter was altered on the Lord's Day by the Pope. So the Pope Leo is given the sermon for Easter.
Yes, Monday.
Easter Sunday himself. Easter Sunday, Easter Monday. Now you're boundless. So would you like to pay me for this privilege? 10 grand. I don't know. Very demanding. How about 3 grand? It's demanding. We're at a point in our life where we'll just take 1,000. Good. That's fine.
Farewell.
We get 3 grand for talking to you, so let's go on and talk to...
Yes, sire.
The huge white faction, Powys. Got a lot of bagpipes going off in the background. So here we are. Glyus. Gluius Gloiger. Sounds particularly Welsh. That's fine. Oh, and the rebels are buggered off somewhere. That's nice of them. Ah. Ah, we're still Catholic. Druist, well, I'm not sure what we're doing is intelligent by changing the religion. But it's part of the theme of it. Right, here we go. We've got 3,053 men. They got 1,046. So this, in theory, should be a fantastic victory. We can't really afford to sit outside of it and just siege them out. So we need to be making some money from somewhere. And here we go, we're going to be taking the Legion Fort of somewhere. Start deployment. Now, does it make more sense to go on the wall where I suspect we're going to lose an awful lot of men? What are you? Are you a horse? He is a horse. That's good. Oh, that's cool. You get little Celtic symbols where your troops go. That's nice. I think we're just going to... Oh, I've not done my... No, that's annoying. I've not done my hotkeys because I was too keen to play the thing. That shows how little I've actually played it. So what we're going to do is we're just make a hole in the gate and we're just going to push through. Is me plan. Now... This music sounds an awful lot like it's from Braveheart. We'll just let them shoot at us. Are they going to set the rams on fire? Is it even doing anything? I don't think it is, but we've got a hell of a lot of archers, so that should be helpful. And again, we're on that point where actually people dying doesn't really affect us at the minute.
The battering ram is in place. It'll not be long before our enemy's defences fall.
What have we lost? We've lost 1%, but they've lost 4. Our mighty archers. These ones are the core ones, the marksmen. Anything with that name just makes me think they're good. Now, some of you will write lengthy essays as to why I haven't bothered putting them into loose formation. And the point is, they don't fire as effectively, is my thinking. And we've got loads of these. This is just normal bowmen. We've got some just knocking around in that fort that we put them in. Right, let's get a wiggle on. Let's go. We can drop the siege equipment, which apparently is the letter J. We killed 9% of their army. That's good.
The battering ram has done its work. Now is the time.
Time to push through.
And brave deeds.
So you're ready. Let's just go, boys. Let's go. What's run? Apparently it's H. Oh, we'll have to sort this out for the second episode. But we're just...
The Lord is with us today. We've captured the enemy's walls.
Right, let's just, we can't sit around here all day. Let's just get everybody in. Gone for a mad charge at the walls. Now that welcome message said that you're going to lose more men in the archers and cavalry skirmish. So this is, we're going to call this normal. Look at that, they're getting battered. Sailor archers. Avengers of Britain, ooh, they look cool. Well, I know their stats. 33 defense. Oh, they're nice. We want some of them. If that, I imagine it's possible because they're a rebel. They're a free people faction in Wales, which makes me think that we can train everything that they can train. Look at that. Beep, beep, boys. Beep, beep. Let's kill these fools. What are these? Irish pirates in the back. No, they're not. They're urban militia.
The battle is very much in our favour. If we remain true and steadfast, victory will be ours.
Well, What can we... We probably want our champions to take out the Avengers of Britain. Elite against elite. And we've run out of arrows, actually. That was quick. So there's no point having you there anymore, just in case you're shot at. Oh, R isn't run. We've got some missile carry, that's nice. We have not really thought about this battle at all. We've just kind of charged and hoped for the best. That's not really a thing then. They apparently have a special ability of a war crime. I don't know why that isn't available. Never mind. Where's our champions gone? Kill the Avengers of Britain. They just have a cool name that makes me think I would like them. Still got some archers shooting at us.
Good tidings.
There you go.
The enemy general lies dead. We've sent the base curtain.
That's what happens when you just mass charge people. And it's what happens when a general is a mounted missile unit. Not really formidable in melee. His name we can't pronounce, so we'll just move on. Can't even do anything with our own general. Come on, where are our champions? They should look really cool in my head.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
Where are you? Oh, you're stuck in this block here. So let's get you to actually throw your little javelins over here. Oh, hello, what are these? Let's get... I don't know at the minute. I'm just clicking on units that I think are close. Hopefully enough men die that we can restart the economy. Oh, some of them are on the walls. Let's have a look at them. Oh, they look pretty cool. They look like little Vikings, don't they? There's 133 of ours, there's only 63 of theirs left. My god, that's a win. We've only got 8 of those units left. There's... Get the Irish pirates. Take out those watchmen. What else have we got here? These spears. Ooh, let's do something with them. There you go, round you go. Oh, that's not run. Hopefully I'm going to take the town. I wonder what the time limit on the town is going to be. This is that nervous point where this is the point where when I was York it crashed when I took the town. Hopefully the live address aware, is that what it is? The large address aware? Hopefully that's going to have an impact. It hasn't been a bit dodgy. Normally you can tell when some of the buttons start swapping their icons. So if we go standing there, you'll keep noticing that for some reason what I think is run is zoom in a little bit, and we don't want to do that. Right, let's take them from behind. Charge, my watchman. Göring goop. It is a very cool looking mod. Let's start with the positives. Hopefully they shit themselves when I run at their back. Yes. Poke them with your pointy sticks. Oh, they're wavering. It sounds very much like the music when Mel Gibson in Braveheart goes around and kills the generals that betrayed him at the Battle of Falkirk. And he rides into someone's... So being in the square means bugger all as well. Let's not do that then. Who have we got? If we go here... Sorry, zooming in when we shouldn't be. So, there is a very sort of Scottish... Oh, hang on, we're running away. Let's just get them. Take out that eye. So when you're doing a siege, it appears you don't have to... take the town square like in every other Total War game. So it's all about killing everybody. Which actually, now you think about it, might make it quite easy. All the Avengers of Britain have gone! Right, let's send our champions to go take these sailor archers. Where have the Avengers gone? Oh, cool! They're already firing at them. That's nice. You see, we have a problem now, is that they don't want to go and kill them. That's fine.
This is a clear victory.
Let's see who our most effective great virtue and valor. Men killed. Now, I've been recording the new Legolas and Thranduil campaign, so Legolas normally routinely gets like 800 kills, and 133 being the top amount. Is going to take some serious getting used to, but we did it. We've got a settlement. That's a nice little nest egg to start with, and hopefully our economy will get a bit of a boost, because we're going to get 18 grand.
My lord, our courage and honour have conquered.
And he's a rebel as well. Now, what can we get from? Right.
My liege. Aye, sire.
So if we just leave him there, we'll take you lot.
Aye, lord. As you wish.
We've encountered the other people. The Dumonominunians.
Aye, sire. Hail my king.
Any more spears in there? We'll put...
Aye, lord.
Like that. By your command. Combining so we'll put like that. There should be one left. And then we'll put forces, you in yes. there. And then yes, next go, sir. We're going to take Caer Gwent. It's all going rather well. What could possibly go wrong? And we're still on minus 23, so we haven't sorted the economy out just yet. I'm wondering if this is what I'm supposed to do, or if I'm supposed to... disband the armies. We'll see. they've come back. Now, they left last time, so... And I think Caerlyn looks... And I'm not basing this on anything other than...
We must prevail.
This looks very built up as a settlement. This is a wooden wall, and it's a large Roman town. So my interpretation is that this is going to be a better win than them taking whatever this rubbish is. What's our diplomatic status with this massive country in the middle, Powys? Oh, we're neutral, so that's okay. Let's see if we get an alliance with them whilst we quietly conquer all of South Wales. Sire.
Tomorrow's journey planned out, sire.
Two Irish factions are at war. The Jutes and the Saxons are allies, and the Saxons and Dumnomnia, Cornwall, basically, are having a ceasefire. Romans winning everything, apart from the South Angles. Interesting. Didn't say that the South Angles made a lot of money at the start of the game. I wonder what they've done differently. So we'll siege it for another turn. And then as long as there's no crashes, this will be a successful video that gets uploaded whilst I pop outside for some fresh air. And then this will... I'm not going to record these... like I normally do. I normally record sort of a batch of three, release them, and then I record them at the weekend. These are Bledic of Mon. I don't think I can afford to have another general knocking around. Our ruler has fallen. Oh, sugar.
Hail my king.
Can you get out of there?
Sire, your will, sir, as you wish.
Oh my god, why does it take you so long to get to him? Well, tough, they're always under siege anyway, we can't do anything about that.
Assembling a mighty host of your troops, sire.
So we have a new king. And, oh, I forgot to show you, if you put it on Petty King of Demet, or Daffyd, it tells you that we are a king level 1. I can't use my mouse, otherwise the icon goes. It says that we're a petty king. He's important, he's wealthy, he's feared, but to some degree. In many circles, he is still only seen as a petty king among many others vying for supremacy. To achieve the higher level of eminent kingship and be named as landholder or juletic, he must hold 15 settlements, the following among them. His own capital, so basically Wales, that says to me. And then there's another one afterwards. Oh, he's legitimate, that's okay. And we haven't had any effects from our druidization process as well. So hopefully,
hail my king.
In the next episode, we will be taking Caer Gwent, and hopefully that will sort the economy out. We'll have 2, 4, 6 regions. So like I said, we're recording these sort of as and when I get time, because I went back to work today and there's an awful lot to do in teaching, I'm afraid. So I will have time to read your comments and your suggestions before posting episode 2, because it'll just be when I have the ability to do so. On a slight note, the suggestion that I fix my smoke alarm whilst all there it goes again. I can't. I have tried everything. I have lived in this house for 10 years and I do not know how to stop it from beeping, and I am very sorry. The only thing that I can say, as I wrote to the many people who watched the overview of this mod, is try and think of it as one of the quirks and the quaint sort of kooky parts of the channel. And please do continue watching. Please leave as many comments as you'd like about where you think we should go. Once we've taken Caer Gwent, should we ride north and betray the other Welsh faction, or should we unite with them and try and take on the might of Powys? Because nobody knows what we're doing, and I don't. So Powys, the thing I need to kill, Gwen, oh no, I don't need to kill these. So if I get an alliance with this fella, this massive white fella that stretches all the way from the estuary of the Thames, he goes all the way through the East Midlands up to roughly where they're going to build Offa's Dyke in about 300 years, about 200 years, I think. But they've already got into Wales. So we've got to talk to them quickly, or we're going to... Where's my
yes,
fella?
My lord.
Ah, let's do that before we yes, save sir. The episode. Let's How see if we England would like to you? Be friends. You got some money, so let's have 1,000 for the privilege. And military access.
It's good Boom. To see we could reach
So now. We're allied An with the superpower of the Farewell. Age. That's good. It's a good way to conclude the video. And we shall leave it there.
Orders.
But look how big. They've gone into Wales already, so we need to secure southern Wales. And then I think... Oh, hello. It's taking its time. We've encountered York. And we've encountered the Saxons. And the South Angles. Hopefully that's it for now. Hopefully we're going to make some money. I think the best way of making money is taking settlements and then sacking them to the ground. So we can't do anything there. So maybe we need to cross. Oh, I'd love to know what this piece of water is. I should know it because I live like here. Like it's not far from where I live at all. It's about 2 hours drive. But never mind. So we'll leave it there for the episode. Thank you very much for watching. I do... wish you well this evening. Feel free to write any comments, any criticisms, as if they're polite. Just ignore the fire, the smoke alarm. I can't do anything about that, I'm afraid, until I move house. So unless you're going to write to my school and tell them what a wonderful teacher I am, I think you're just going to have to just put up with it. I do apologise as much as I can. But thank you very much for watching. Do take care of yourselves, and goodbye for now.